Hello friends, today's topic is PK structure. And PK structures, there are three major structures: wave PK, figure PK and figure fast PK. Now in wave PK we have this type of motif. Okay, what we learned in weld structures that we have two strands of warp yarns. One is face and another is stitching. Okay, so in weld structure we fill stitching threads only on few specific picks. Okay, like all the stitching threads were lifted on some few specific picks only. And in PK structure the stitching threads are filled in particular fashion, like this particular motif. Okay, so this particular motif is filled in all the stitching threads. Okay, so to prepare a PK waved PK structure we have this particular motif for stitching threads. To design a PK weave, waved PK weave, okay, we first of all we have to select how many warp and weft are required for one weave repeat. Okay, in the motif what we have seen here, in this particular motif we have 6 stitching ends and 12 picks. Okay, like this motif, this left hand side motif has 6 picks and similarly 6 picks for this right hand side motif. Okay, so now to make a PK structure we need for 6 stitching threads we need 12 face threads, because our structure was FSF. Okay, for every single stitching thread we have 2 face threads. Okay, so to prepare a PK weave for that particular motif which have 6 stitching threads we require 18 ends. Why 18 ends? Because we have 2 face ends for each stitching threads, so we have 6 stitching threads, so 12 face ends, and hence it totals up to 18, and the pattern is FSF. And for picks we had 12 picks in our motif. Okay, so in this particular weave we require 12 picks for normal fabric and 4 additional wadded picks. Okay, so these will be in this pattern F 6 face picks, then 2 wadded picks, then again 6 face picks and again 2 wadded picks. Okay, so in this way we have total of 12 and 4, 16 picks. So our grid will be 18 by 16. Okay, 18 by 16. So to prepare this weave we require to fill all the face ends in plain weave. Okay, so except for wedded pics. So like for this, if this is face, and if first one is up, then second is down, then this one up, third is down, then this one up, then this is down, and then skip these two wedded. Okay, so if this one was down, then this is up again, and this is down, then this is up, this is down, this is up, this is down, and then skip these two also. Now in the next face, faces here, these are the stitching ends. We mark these. These are the stitching ends. As we can see here. So we just mark these stitching ends. Now, sorry, because my screen is a little small. Now for next face pick, first one was down, up, so this is down, this is up, this is down, this is up, this is down, this is up, then skip these two, then this is down, and this is up, down, up, down, up. Okay, similarly next. Okay, so in this way we have filled all the face picks in face ends in plain weave, face ends and face picks in plain end, and we have left these wedded ends. Okay, now we fill these stitching ends. These are the stitching ends, this one, this one, this one, these red colors. Okay, so we select red color for this, and we have to fill that particular motif in these stitching ends, which was like this. Here we have taken red color for stitching ends. In exam, where if you don't have colors, then you can use some other methods, like you can use circles for stitching ends. Then add for that you have to specify that these circles mean stitching ends. So let's, sorry, these will be, so let's take circles for now. We have to fill these stitching ends. These are the stitching ends, S. Okay, and we fill stitching ends in that particular motif. Okay, we have to fill that motif into these stitching ends. Okay, and for that we take red color and we mark these as circles, okay, like this. So that motif was like this. Okay, now next, leave these two wedded ends and then again fill the same motif in stitching ends. Okay, now we are left with only wedded picks. For that we mark them like this, and these wedded picks, as we know, are only up in face ends and down on the stitching ends. So we fill them like this. Similarly, the upper wedded ends. Okay, remember one thing always, you can choose any symbol to represent any ends or any picks. Like we have chosen this yellow mark for wedded picks, and we have chosen this cross, white cross, for face picks, and these red circles for stitching ends. Okay, but you have to specify them. Okay, for exam purpose you have to specify them that we have used this particular mark for wedded picks. And what this means is that wedded picks are down on all the face ends and up on all the stitching ends. Okay, so as this face end is up on this wedded picks, okay, so all the face ends are up on the wedded picks and all the stitching ends are down in the wedded picks. Okay, so this is the waved pique structure. Next one is figured pique structure. For the figured pique structure, we need to implement this particular motif in the pique weave. Okay, so in this motif, we can see, we have four stitching threads. Okay, so four stitching threads, we require 8 face threads, so total number of ends are 8 plus 4, 12. Okay, similarly we require 12 ends, and those 12 ends are arranged in this particular manner, like 2 face ends, then 1 wedded end, then 2 face end, then 1 wedded pick, then 2 face picks and 1 wedded pick, then 2 face pick and 1 wedded pick. In earlier one we had all the face picks all together, then 2 wedded picks, a line of 2 wedded picks, then face picks, and then 2 wedded picks were combined together. For this figured pique structure, we split these wedded picks in this particular fashion, like 2 face picks, then wedded pick, then 2 face picks, then wedded pick. And to make this weave, we need to fill all the face picks in face ends, face picks and face ends in plain weave. Okay, so this time we use circle for plain weave of face ends. So if this one is up, this is down, then skip the weighted end. Then this is up, this is down, then skip this. This is up, this is down, then this is up. Similarly, the next one. Okay, similarly, another one. This is down, skip the weighted ends in between and fill all the face peaks in and face ends, okay, in plain weave. Okay, next step is filling of the stitching ends. So as we know, the stitching ends are filled in face picks in this particular motif fashion. In this motif, we, as we can see, there are only 4 face picks and 4 stitching ends, and in the weave we have 8 face picks and 4 stitching ends. So we just double the face picks. Okay, so we have to fill these in the set of 2. Like this, mark it as cross. Next one was this one. So skip the weighted end and fill the face ends. Next one was this one, and next one was these two. So as we can see here, we just double this the number of picks in this particular motif. Okay, here we have stitching end in first face pick only, but in this particular in this final weave, we lifted the stitching end for consecutive 2 face picks. Okay, so as per motif, we have filled all the stitching ends and face picks, and face end and face picks. Now the wedded ends, sorry, wedded picks. For as we know, wedded picks are only down on the face ends. Okay, and picks are up on the stitching end. So as the picks are up, so we will left this particular box empty. This where wedded picks and stitching end. Okay, and when picks are down, as for the face picks, face ends, we mark them. So this is the final figured pique structure. Okay, that's all for today. Thank you very much.